My name is Patrick Vollmann, and I'm presenting our work about a rotationally invariant convolution module by feature map back rotation. This was joint work with Tobias Botke, and we are both doing our PhD at TUM and working at Ambitech Software GmbH. If you see an image like this, it will be no surprise that a CNN that was pre-trained on ImageNet can classify it correctly. But if you rotate the image, then you will get a surprise because the image will not be classified correctly. And if you rotate the images in steps of 10 degrees, you get various different results, but only sometimes the correct one. And this is due to the fact that CNN features are generally not rotationally invariant. And this is also the motivation for our work. So convolutions are, of course, translation invariant. Let's take an example. If you apply those two dummy filters to this dummy image, then you will get these feature maps. And if you rotate the image, then you will get two completely different feature maps. And so it's no surprise that in the end, the classifier cannot interpret these feature maps correctly. There was some previous work done already, and in particular, the idea came up to rotate the convolution filters and then pooling over the rotations or over the feature maps that were generated by the rotated filters. So first you take some input filters, you rotate them, let's say, four times, you get four feature maps for each of the filters, then you pool over the different rotations and you get two output feature maps. This leads to a rotation equivariant features, but the problem is still that you have to train with rotated images to make the algorithm work in the end. Let's see some examples or a dummy example. So we have our two dummy filters. We rotate them with 90 degrees rotations four times, and then we get four different feature maps for each of the filters. And if we pool over these four feature maps, then we get two output feature maps. If we rotate the input image, then we do the same, but we end up again with two feature maps that are quite similar to the other ones, but they are not invariant, but only equivariant. So our idea was that before we pool over the feature maps, we rotate them back. So we add one more step here to back rotate the filters with respect to the angle that the feature maps with respect to the angle that the filter has been rotated before. And let's see also an example here. If you use an upright image and you apply your rotated filters, you get rotational convolution outputs as before. But now you back rotate these feature maps, and if you pool over them, you get some strangely looking feature maps in this example. But the good thing is that if you rotate the input image now, then you will get exactly the same and you have rotational invariance. We did some experiments, and the main objective was that we wanted to train only on upright data, but evaluate also on rotations of the test images. So we took MNIST, and for the test images, we rotated each image in steps of 10 degrees to obtain MNIST ROT 36. And we did the same also for Cypher 10 and Cypher 100. And one thing that we did here was to crop the images circularly, because otherwise, if you rotate the images, you get some artifacts. And of course, we had to do the same cropping also for the training images. But again, the training images were only upright. And if you see the results, we can outperform the equivariant models here. And what we also found that if we position the rotationally invariant convolution module at different positions in the CNN, then it needs to be in the first layer already to obtain reasonable results. And also, if you increase the number of rotations, you get better. And on cipher 10 and 100, this is a little bit more difficult, but still we can outperform previous equivalent models on this task. Thank you, and see you later at the